Hey everyone, I'm Trevor and you're watching SoCal Disney Dad. Today we are at EPCOT here in Walt Disney World in Orlando, Florida, and we're gonna have some fun, so let's get going. It is 10:42 and Spaceship Earth does not appear to be open. I'm not sure if that's just because it's not 11 or what that is, but we're gonna head to the World Showcase and maybe try to do Frozen. Depending on when you come, EPCOT might look drastically different than the last time you remember it. They've got these big black walls everywhere and they're pointing you off in different directions. So World Showcase is technically through there, but we can't get that way. So we have to go around this building, all the way around, and then zip up back by Test Track. So it's kind of convoluted and really, really out of the way, but 10:45 and it says Test Track has a 70 minute wait. Looks like the pyramid or whatever you call it, Mayan temple for Mexico is not yet open. Lots of people here lining up for that and they're just sitting there. That won't open until 11 o'clock. All right, here we are arriving at Frozen at probably about 10:50. I haven't actually checked the clock, but that would be my guess. And it doesn't look bad at all. Looks like we're gonna be able to walk straight on in to the ride. Amy will, of course, put the timer on. It does say 15 minutes. Hello. It does say 15 minutes up on the standby sign. So that is a good thing. This will probably be the shortest it will be all day. We're approaching the Mexico Pavilion here, and it is actually a very, very small area. The entirety of the pavilion is inside this Mayan temple, with the exception of a dining location here off to my left. But besides that dining location, everything else about this pavilion is inside here. If you want to come in, I recommend coming early because the line can get quite busy as time. Hello! Can get quite busy and difficult to make it in. The Gran Fiesta Tour is in here, as well as the San Angel Inn, which is the dining place that overlooks. So right now it is like 11:05, 11:10. We're able to just walk straight in. The line here does tend to fill up. This is a popular ride.
Excuse me, we are looking for a dog.
Oh, ay, ay, ay.
Never mind.
Now we are heading inside the Walt Disney Imagineering EPCOT experience. So I'm not sure which way you're supposed to go, but let's go this way.
cultures and ideas from around the world.
Here's a look at what they might be doing in the new show. Check out the line for Frozen now as we're heading over in here into the China Pavilion. Pretty much most of China is closed at the moment because they're using it to waive all of the Frozen line. We definitely made the right decision in rope dropping, and we use that term loosely. There is no rope, there is no drop anymore. But going straight to Frozen this morning was the best decision because this line is long. So our first food item of the festival for today, and we're just gonna be snacking around the World Showcase because we had a big breakfast. Crab and cheese wontons. So these look really good. It's one of the larger portion items, I think, because there's three and they're very decent sized wontons. I mean, they're good normal sized wontons, but they look really, really great. And I'll just let Amy go ahead and start off with the first bite.
I expected them to be a little bit more crispy, but they're good.
I like them when they're soggy.
And then you'll like these.
And I'll like them?
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's go ahead and try. So what I tend to do first is bite off the ends and then I get a big old bite of the cream cheese. I do love these, wow. Good cream cheese and crab in the center. Amy prefers the crunchy parts on the top. I prefer the soft, chewy part on the inside. Mm-hmm. Very, very good. If you like cream cheese wontons, don't pass these up. We're walking by the China Pavilion and I'm choosing not to go in there and tour China just because so much of the area is being used for queue space, whether it be reflections of China or whether it be Frozen. Just so much of it is queue that it's hard to walk around and enjoy what you used to be able to enjoy. However, it does look like we can come up and see these panda topiaries, and this is a great topiary, good spot just to show this one aspect here of China. Here we are approaching Italy, coming in from the Germany side, and it looks like their new gelato place is open, so I think we're gonna grab something from the gelateria, if that's how you pronounce it. Just outside the Italy Pavilion here in EPCOT, the Gelateria Toscana has just opened. We have been told from the cast members there that today was the opening day at 12:30 and it is 12:45. We are literally one of the first 10 people or so to try the new gelato place here in the Italy Pavilion. So this is gonna be completely unedited. I'm on my phone and I'm literally just gonna record this, our first impressions, first thoughts, and then we're gonna upload it to YouTube. So we'll see how that goes. But we've got just a simple gelato here. We didn't venture out into much anything else, but we've got chocolate and stracciatella. Stracciatella is the chocolate chip variety. So let's head on over here. And
we did see that some people were getting big float type looking ones, sundae yep. looking ones, but we went basic.
I was really interested to see if they had the gelato cookie sandwiches that the other place has, but they don't. That's okay. They've got sundaes, they've got floats, they even have espresso poured over gelato on one of the items, and so lots of different choices for you. The regular ice cream comes in two scoops only, that comes in a waffle cone or in a cup, and we chose to get it in a cup. It's a little cheaper that way. You can pay a little extra for the waffle cone, and they'll put it over upside down in a cup anyway, but Amy's taking a bite here, and
it's good, but it's melting fast, so.
It's melting fast.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is a hot, hot Thursday afternoon here for us. We are enjoying Epcot, having a blast today. You can see beautiful weather. We do have some clouds, which the clouds occasionally bring shade, and there's wind blowing in, so we're having a pretty decent day here this morning so far. As you can already tell, yeah, it is getting very, very glassy looking from melting. So I'm gonna go ahead.
Oh yeah, it's like pouring off.
Yeah. I'm gonna go ahead and just have a quick bite here. Very good gelato. Definitely very good. Our next item of the festival here is this crawfish etouffee. It's on dirty rice. You can't see the rice, and I don't want to tilt the bowl too much because, yeah, it's gonna tip out. But we're here in the America Pavilion with this beautiful fountain backdrop, and we're being serenaded by the Voices of Liberty down in that pavilion down that way. That's pretty good.
It's like Kimbalaya. I mean, I know it's not.
It's Cajun food.
Yeah.
So the third item that we're getting today is a shrimp and crab. Shrimp and crab that is on top of a cucumber by the looks of it. Looks pretty good. It's also kind of like a little hidden Mickey there. Not quite. So in this vlog video, we're just basically walking around the World Showcase, and we are eating our way around the world, snacking around the world, if you will, from the Flower and Garden Festival here. But if you would like to see more in-depth tours of the different lands here at Epcot, we are recording many of those. We probably won't do every single pavilion, but we're recording many of them, and those will be at a later posting. So go ahead and hit the like and subscribe button if you want to see those. I will fully admit that I personally am not much of a shopping person. So as we walk through the shops, I give you just kind of overviews. And if you're wanting in detail merchandising videos, that's not going to be what you're going to get. But in each of the pavilions, they often have like little museum type things. And I love looking at the museums. We love zoos, we love museums, and so we focus on those. And while there's just so much that I can't possibly record everything, I do highlight a few of those things, and you can see them. The one that we were just in, at the Japan Pavilion on the Kawaii cute culture in Japan, I absolutely loved the little model apartment for what a Japanese woman would have. And it was really, really great. Highly recommend you check out that video whenever it posts. Now we have the duck confit on gnocchi at the France Pavilion, or France booth. I'm surprised that they have gnocchi, because gnocchi is an Italian thing.
Maybe it's also
French. Maybe so. I know we haven't really been filming our food. We've been showing you what it looks like before we eat it, but we haven't been actually filming eating it. And that's just because we're just kind of moving along the World Showcase here. It's kind of hot. Mm-hmm. There's a cloud cover over at the moment, which is kind of nice, but it's just like, we're just gonna eat, we're gonna move on. But to talk about it as we walk here, the shrimp and crab from the Japan Pavilion, I don't believe we talked about that, was very tiny, very not filling at all.
But it was
so
refreshing.
Well, I'm glad you think so. And see, that's why we have different opinions. Different thoughts. Amy thought it was great. For me, I thought it was not very good for your money, just because.
Oh, well, I didn't say that.
Well, that's the way I'm looking at it. Pretty much all the way I look at food. I mean, food can be, you know, to die for, but if the portion size isn't sufficiently large enough, I don't see the value in buying really, really expensive food. It was good. Certainly no complaints about the shrimp and crab for the taste. But just not very big. There's another item that we passed up on earlier for that very same reason. You got 5 little like cheese balls for $12. And it just didn't seem like a good value. But the duck was good. Hey, I liked the duck. The gnocchi. I love me a good gnocchi. And yeah, I would get that again. Amy wasn't sure if it was duck, but I'm pretty sure it was.
Probably. It just didn't taste as ducky as...
A ducky?
Yeah, I don't think that's the word, but as ducky as some dishes I've had.
Imagination. Dun, 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 dun. We're going to go ride Journey into the Imagination with Figment.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to our special drive-through open house. I'm Dr. Nigel Channing, Chen of the Imagination Institute. Hello! On your tour, you'll see how the five human senses can help capture your imagination.
This is on. Hello?
Hello?
Who is this?
It's Figment!
Figment? I thought I told you not to interfere.
But you got it wrong, Doc. It's not about listening with your ears. It's about listening with your imagination.
Follow the bouncing Figment.
What spark of light can light your fancy? Your mind sees more than what your eyes see. Your sense of sight can make your fancy fly.
And so, as you can plainly see, imagination works the best when it's set free.
You said it, Doc! Imagination is a blast!
And here is Soarin' over here. It is currently a 60-minute wait, so we are not going to ride Soarin'. I can't film it anyway, so it wouldn't make it into the video. But we have ridden Soarin' plenty of times, and it is definitely a fun ride. And it probably is 60 minutes because this is a slow-moving ride. We're going to come over here to Seasons and just get some ice water. You can eat food here. This is a quick service, but we are just grabbing some water. As we come out of living with the land, well, out of the land in general, we come out here and everything's wet. Must have downpoured while we were in there. We thought we heard something while we were on Living with the Land because it's a greenhouse and you could hear like, you know, something like rain or running water.
I guess like one of the fans in there.
Yeah, it could have been something on the ride for all we knew. Something we didn't get to do on a Saturday that Amy really wanted to do was go in the Goodness Garden Butterfly House. So that's where we're going. Amy got one on her finger.
And I'm going to take him back in. So, take open the
thing. He escaped.
He escaped. I brought him back in.
There are lots and lots of butterflies in here.
This is like the San Diego Zoo. It's a Safari Park Butterfly House, but...
They're really, really teeny tiny.
So, on the camera?
Yeah, on the camera.
It's okay, butterflies. I'm not gonna hurt you, I just wanna get nice and close. There we go. How cool are you?
So between the 2 days here at EPCOT, I wanted to ride all the rides. Now, I already mentioned we're not going to ride Soarin', probably because it's too long of a line. We'll check later and we'll see. But we're going to head to Mission Space now, and then we're going to re-ride Spaceship Earth, because why not? As we're walking along here, I've noticed that Disney's alternative to live entertainment is playing the music of live entertainment over the loudspeaker. And a couple of times I've found myself looking for the drummers or the live entertainment that I'm used to at EPCOT, and they're not there. And I'm like, where's that noise coming from? Oh, a speaker. It's kind of disappointing, but it probably is because they're just so short-staffed and things, and maybe it'll come back. Maybe it won't, because Disney was cutting live entertainment even before the pandemic. So it's hard to say exactly what's gonna happen with that, but I hope it comes back.
It's a secret mission in uncharted space.
And we're gonna go on that secret mission. But it's not an uncharted space.
Oh, is there really 30 minutes for either side?
Oh.
Oh.
Never mind. I am not riding this if it's 30 minutes. I've ridden it plenty of times, it's not exciting.
Yeah.
Just because the line is long and I don't wanna ride it, doesn't mean that I can't enjoy this Mission Space logo and the area. I'm a space person. I like space. I like space video games. I like space books. I like space movies. And the Mission Space Orange version is better, in my opinion, because it goes to Mars. The green one used to go to Mars, then they changed it. Now it just goes to the International Space Station. But it doesn't make you puke. To infinity and beyond. Apparently I need this mug. But I don't drink things out of mugs.
Ooh, I like the clear one.
The clear ones?
I don't know why. I'm like a sucker for clear mugs. I love clear mugs.
I like these, like the classic black. San Diego Zoo has ones very, very similar to this. If you've seen my videos on merchandise, I really like those.
I still haven't figured out how to turn this thing off.
I was hoping that there was like a solid mode, but I can't figure it out. There's something about Spaceship Earth at night. Just the colors that they put on it. Last ride of the night for us, Spaceship Earth. As with just about everybody else, considering there is a 30-minute wait. And we didn't time it, but it's probably pretty close. Amy's timing it. What is it? 14 minutes. Okay, that's not close to 30 minutes. But Spaceship Earth, I'm not going to film the ride. We did that last time. Catch you on the other side. Hey everyone, so it's the next morning and I realized that I never said goodbye last night. We were just so tired. So I'm gonna say goodbye now. That's it for our time in our EPCOT video yesterday. If you wanna see more videos from our Walt Disney World vacation, go ahead and hit like and subscribe. And we will see you again next time. Actually, we're gonna see you again real soon because we're going to Animal Kingdom right now.